In this lecture, I'd like to show you how you can create a non-standard column chart or an info chart in Excel, like this one. Some time ago, Udemy published a very informative and interesting report that had this chart in it. It grabbed my attention and I was like, wow, I really want to make this in Excel. That's what I'm going to show you how to do in this lecture. The thing I like about this chart is that it's informative, it's also visually appealing, and it's different to what people are used to seeing, so they pay more attention. Now this chart, this is something that people are used to seeing. Some of you see this every single day. It is visually effective because it brings attention to the key chart elements that need emphasis. But if I put these side by side, which one grabs your attention more? For me personally, this one definitely grabbed my attention. I wanted to create it in Excel in a way that it's also dynamic, so it saves you time whenever new data comes in. Now the highlighted part, the part that's conditionally formatted, is something that I also wanted to make dynamic depending on the condition. In this example, I have some random data on the number of users per weekday that are logged into the system, and I want to highlight the weekday that had the maximum number of users logged in. So if I get new data and Tuesday happens to be 600, everything will update automatically. First, I'll show you how to get this dynamic conditional formatting effect, and then I'm going to show you how you can bring shapes in chart, and finally, how to tweak them for optimal effect, because we don't want to have stretched out shapes. So let's start with the conditional formatting part. This is the data table which we're going to use to create our amazing chart. We have the number of users per weekday, and we're going to start off by inserting a very basic column chart. Now let's just make some minor adjustments, so remove grid lines, remove axes, add data labels. Let's decrease the gap width so that they're closer together. Let's go with 70%. I'm going to update the title so that it basically equals this. Take away the border. So I have this in my quick access toolbar. That's the outline. If you don't have it, you can get to it by going to format and removing the shape outline from here. So while I'm here, let's also change the shape fill to a gray. That's the basic chart. Now I want to conditionally format this so that the weekday that has the most users becomes automatically another color. If I were to do this manually, so here Thursday has 500, right? I could click again on it and change the shape fill of only this one category to green, but it's not dynamic because if Tuesday is 600, this is going to remain green and that's not. So what I want to happen is that this one becomes green and this one, the Thursday, turns back to gray. Now here's the key that whenever you want to conditionally format anything in your charts, you need to add a new data series. What I'm going to do is add a data series that basically consists of only one bar, and that bar is only going to pop up whenever I have the maximum. So basically everything else is going to be zero, but only there where the maximum number is, I'm going to have, let's say, a green bar. I need a new series. The series is going to have zeros and that maximum number, but that maximum number has to pop up adjacent to the category. So my formula is going to be if this equals the max of this data set, and I'm going to press F4 to fix it because I want to copy it down. If that's the case, then give me back this number. So if that's the maximum, otherwise give me zero. And let's copy this down. So that's my max series. Now I'm going to add this to my chart by going to select data, add, that's the name of the series. Always, always include the series name in your chart, otherwise you're gonna mix them up. And that's that. So it's plotting it beside it, but that's something I can easily change. So I'm going to go here to series option, make sure that I select the whole series, and I'm going to change the fill color first to a green. And now I'm going to go here, and for series overlap, you see there are minus 27, that's why there's a bit of space between them. I'm going to change it to 100%. So now this one is on top of the other series. The order of it is basically defined by this. See, if I push this one down, you see the gray is covering the green. If I push it back up, the green is covering the gray. But for the other data sets, it's all zero. That's why this gray is the only one that's being covered by the green. This is fully dynamic because if I change Tuesday to 600, it jumps. So that's the first step. Now, how do I bring shapes to charts? So how do I change the shape of this to something else? So let me just take a copy of this and paste it here. From insert shapes, I can pick a shape that I want. I want to have the one that is a bit rounded at the edges. That's this one. So just draw it out here. You can turn it around and change the color to my gray and the shape outline to nothing. Just take it away. That's the shape, let's say, that I want to use. All I have to do to replace these bars with this one is to go Control C on my shape, click on the bar, make sure the entire series is selected, so also the one behind this green one, and go Control V. To get the green one, I have to add that to the second series, because remember, I have two series, right? So if I want my second series to be green and this shape, I have to add that to the series as well. Okay, so I'm going to change this to the green and Control C, click on the maximum series, so that's the one that's highlighted, and go Control V. So now I've added shape to charts and it should be dynamic. So let's go and change Tuesday back to 300. Okay, it jumps back as well. But you see what the problem is here. For the data sets that are bigger, so here for 500, the shape is really pointy and here it's not. Okay, so basically it gets stretched out like this for bigger data sets and becomes like this for smaller data sets. That's something that I want to avoid. To do that, I need to use a trick. And the trick is to basically to split each of these data sets, so the 400, to two data sets. The top data set is going to be identical for all of them, and that's going to be, let's say, this shape. And the bottom data set is going to be a shape that doesn't mind being stretched out, and that shape is a rectangle. To add two data series to this, I could use a stacked column chart. That means I just have to change my data set a little bit. I'm going to copy this part, paste it here. Let's not make it too complex at the beginning. I'm just going to do the gray series first, and then as a last step, we're going to add the green series to it. Okay, so I need to have two stacks. Let's call them stack one and stack two. Stack two is going to be a number that's common to all of them, right? So that can be the minimum of this data set. I'm going to fix it. And now, depending on my data set, I could adjust this even more. I could go divide it by two. If I find that this doesn't really represent my shape quite well, it makes it squashed out, I can change this number. That's the size of my top stack. Now my bottom stack is basically going to be my original value minus my top stack. I'm going to copy that down. Okay, so let's insert this chart. I'm going to highlight this, hold down Control, highlight this, and insert a column chart, but now a stacked column chart. So this is our top stack. They all have the same size, so we don't have the problem of having our shape getting stretched out. Okay, just adding the title, taking these away, and let's reduce the gap width again. I'm going to reduce it even more here. Let's go to 50. Okay, so I need two shapes. That's my shape number one. And my shape number two is going to be the rectangle down here. Let me copy this first and click on this, paste. That looks good. So I can either bring in a rectangle shape here, but since this already seems in sync with this one, I can just change the color of this to the same color. Now, what about the data labels? Well, I have two stacks here, right? In this top stack, I'm going to highlight them, right mouse click and add data labels to it. Let's make them stand out, make them white, bold, and let's get them to be bigger. Okay, but the data label is not showing what I want to show, right? It's showing the size of this stack. So that's not what we want. I want to show basically the value from cells, and the value that I want to show is this. So if you have Excel 2013 or Excel 2016, you can do what I'm doing right now. If you have an older version of Excel, like Excel 2010 or 7, what you have to do is click on each of these data labels and connect them with a formula to your data. Okay, but it's doable, it just takes a bit longer. Let me take away the border of this one. What I also want to do is bring in the axis labels on top of each of these bars. So I can remove the axis completely. How do I do that? Because that's not a part of the axis options. You always have to leave the x-axis on the bottom. You can't bring the labels up there, but you can use a trick. And the trick is, remember we had a stack, right? And the bottom stack can also have data labels. So I can activate them and I can adjust their positioning so that they're on the bottom, inside base. And now all I have to do is do the same trick and use value from cells, but now instead of showing actual numbers, I'm going to show my axis labels and remove these two. So again, let's adjust the formatting. That looks really nice. It's very harmonized. So as a next step, I'm going to get my conditional formatting in there. What I have to do is exactly what we did in the first step here, where we added a max series. We need to have another stacked column chart in here that's going to cover our gray stack if that stack happens to be the maximum. So let's call it stack one max and stack two max. I'm just going to move this a little bit out of the way. Okay. Formula is the same. We need to check if this number equals the max of this series. Press F4. Then, now not show the number, but show the value of stack one, otherwise show zero. That's for Thursday. Now I'm gonna just copy this, press escape, paste this here, and just move this one to stack two, because my if condition is basically the same. So now that I have my series, I need to bring it in my chart. Right mouse click, select data, add. Don't forget the series name. Series values of my first stack is this. Add again. Oh, you can see it popped up right on top. So that's my second stack for the max. And that's the series values. So press enter, like that. So that looks a bit funny, but basically it's a stacked chart, right? So whatever I'm adding to it, it's gonna add it as a separate stack on top. I don't want it to add on top. I actually want it to cover it. So now layering this by 100% is not gonna work in a stacked column chart, right? Because the series overlap is 100%. What I can do instead is to change them to only these two stacks to the secondary axis. So just came back to the chain chart type because I can do them quickly here. So that's the stack 1 max and stack 2 max. See, now it covered it. And the good thing about this is that this is the max series that I'm putting on the secondary axis. I have that same max on the primary axis, so I don't have the problem of my axis, my secondary and my primary axis, not being in sync. They are going to be in sync. So now I can remove this. And for this, well, the green, that's the green that I had, I think. Let's just double check. Should be this one. Now, all I need is to change the tip of that. I'm going to control C this to this shape. So that's stack 2 max, the whole stack 2 max series is highlighted, and I'm going to paste it there. That looks nice. So let's test this. I'm going to change Monday to 500 as well. Let's see what happens. Well, now I have two maximums. And now let's change Tuesday to 600. That one becomes green. That does take some steps, but you just do the setup once and you can use it on different data sets. Let me just bring this up and we can do a quick direct comparison with our first chart. This compared to this is inconspicuous, right? This one really stands out. The first time I saw it, I was really attracted to it. And then I was like, wow, it's actually easy to read as well. So that's how you can set it up in Excel. Now remember, you can use this on any set of data that you want. I suggest that you don't overuse this type of charts. Use them with care in special reports and in dashboards. If you like this type of Excel tutorial, make sure to subscribe so you don't miss out on more advanced Excel techniques that I'm going to share with you. This technique is a part of my upcoming dashboard course that's coming out on Udemy in about 2 months' time. So do check it out because it's going to have a lot of neat techniques in there.